All right, so maybe the last few thoughts on Robocode. This isn't meant to be, by the way, like an all-inclusive every aspect of Robocode. It's more to teach you about the principles of Robocode. And what I thought might be helpful is to take one of these sample robots and open it up and look to see what it's doing. So rather than taking more time to program it myself. Something we have stuff that's already been programmed, and so we can look and see what's going on here. Now, one thing I didn't do in our other robot code, in our regular my robot code, it does. There's other packages that we can import, and so it's going to import the color package so that it can change the color. And then notice it's got the code set up for you. There's a set colors method. If we look in the Robocode API in the robot event, there's a set colors method that says you can pass in the body color, the gun color, and the radar color. And so they've got it all set up, this set colors method. Now, again, the reason we can call the set colors method is because we've extended the robot class, right? And then it calls from the color class, red, blue, and green, and that's the color of our robot. Now, if we go back to the, I just grabbed corners. I don't know if this is a good one. But colors is going to go in, and actually, it uses this individual set color methods, which we could do as well to set all the different parts of the robot, including the gun color or the bullet color and scan color. But it does some interesting things. So notice when it comes in to the class, it creates a class level variable named others, which is going to store the number of other robots in the game. And then it creates an integer called corner and sets it equal to 0. It also does a boolean that says stop when see robot and sets it equal to false initially. And then in the run, it sets all the colors. It sets the others variable equal to the number or equal to get others. And then it calls the go corner method. Now, the go corner method, if we go look in the robot API, there's not going to be any such thing as a go corner method. See, there's no get go corner. This is one that they've just created themselves. So they've created a method called go corner, and so it's going to go to the corner. So it jumps down to this method and says, let's stop when see robot set to false because we don't want to stop anywhere. We just want to get to the corner. And then turn right, and where it's going to turn right to is the normal relative angle of degrees of the corner. So corner is going to, what does corner refer to? This is actually a complicated bot. I don't know why I picked this one, but let's keep looking at it. Corner is set to 0 initially, so that's going to be 0 minus the heading. Now, where's the heading come from? Well, the heading is one of the methods in our robot class. Get heading tells us where our heading is in degrees on the board. So what's our heading? Which way are we facing? Then, so we've turned right, pointing at that desired corner. Now, this normal relative angle degrees, this is actually something else I think that they've imported. Yeah, so there's a Robocode utils normal relative angle and degrees, and that's just because they want to use the normal relative angle and degrees. This is a class that simplifies this process. Again, this is not, I just picked a bot here. This is a little more complicated than maybe what I was looking for, but so the corner 0 minus our heading is which way we're going to turn, which is trying to get us to the corner. And well, we pass that into the normal relative angles and degrees, which will translate it. We turn right to that number of degrees. We set stop when see robot back to true, and then we move ahead 5,000. Now, why 5,000? Well, it's only going to move till it hits a corner, and the board's not going to be bigger than 5,000. So this is turn all the way to the corner. And then once it gets there, it's going to turn left 90 degrees. Oh, I'm sorry. This isn't getting us to the corner. This is getting us to straight. We want, and it turns, if I'd read the comments, this turns to face the wall that's to the right of our desired corner. So we're going to drive straight up into the wall, and then we want to move ahead 5,000. That takes us to the wall. Turn left 90 degrees, and then move ahead 5,000 again, which will take us into the wall, and then we want to turn our gun left 90 degrees, and that's all that method does. Okay, that's the go corner. So then after it's called go corner, it sets gun increment to 3, and then while true, so this is our nonstop loop, it's going to do a for loop. This is kind of interesting. That says, let's set an integer I equal to 0, and then while I is less than 30, we're going to keep doing this, and we're going to increment I by 1 each time. So we're going to turn the gun left, and we turn it left the gun increment. Now the gun increment was set to 3. Now 3 times 30 is 90, so 3 degrees at a time, it's going to tick, 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 tick. And you can kind of watch it work when we play. And then after it gets done with that, it's going to set the gun increment to -1 of itself. So the gun increment was 3. It's going to take 3 times -1, which will give us a -3. So now it's going to turn the gun left negative, which is the same as turning the gun right, and it's going to do that 3 ticks at a time. Tick, 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 all the way back 90 degrees. Then gun increment is -3 times -1 will give us back to a 3, and then it goes tick, 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 back to the left. Okay? And let's watch that much work. So let's watch this when it starts. Let's focus on corners. Now something's interfered because it scanned a robot. Let me restart this and see if it can get to the corner. So it went straight. Now it's going all the way over to the left. It's going to turn 90 degrees, and now it starts its sweep with the gun until it scans a robot, and it's going to scan it. So it's not really doing its sweep now because... Let's try it again. Okay, and once it's still sweeping, but when it scans a robot, then it stops. So we'll look at that in a second. Now it's working its way back the other way. It's going to get down here and then change it back. See, there we go again, back up. So that's what it's doing. So then let's look and see when it scans a robot. Let's look at its on method. So on scanned robot, if stop when see robot is true, so the only time it doesn't do that is when it's turning to get to the wall. It set it to false here, and then it sets it back to true. But if it's false, then we're not going to do any of this. But if it's true, then we're going to call a stop, which is a method, I believe, which will stop us from doing anything. Yeah, stop immediately stops all movement and saves it for a call to resume. And then it calls its own smart fire method. This isn't anything that's in Robocode. This is its own method. And what is it going to pass to the smart fire? Notice it says e.getDistance. So the e refers to the snapshot that was taken of the robot that it just scanned. So that's the e. So get the distance of the robot that we just scanned and pass that to SmartFire method. In the SmartFire method, we pass in the distance that we just got. If that distance is greater than 200, or the energy, our energy, right? This is ours because it's doesn't have the little E in front of it, right? It's our own energy. Is less than 15, then fire with a power of 1. Else, if the robot distance is greater than 50, then fire with a power of 2. Else, fire with a power of 3. Okay, so that's the condition. It's its own little smart fire method that was built. This is nothing in the robot class. There's no smart fire method in here. Once it calls the smart fire method, then it's immediately going to call another scan to see if the robot's still there, rather than turning again or anything. It's going to immediately call a scan and say, is there something else in the way? And then if we scan a robot, it's going to go back into this process. Okay? And then, if it doesn't scan anything, then we'll resume what we were doing. Okay? If stop when robot is false, then it's going to come down here to the else and then just call smart fire without stopping or resuming or scanning. It's just going to fire the one time. So that's what it does when it scans a robot. Okay, what else do we have? Well, on death, if others is zero, then don't do anything. But if the others is less than, sorry, if the number of others is minus get others divided by the cast the others variable to a double is less than 0.75, if 75% of the robots are still alive when we die, that's so this is what this calculation is doing, is it's trying to figure out if there's 75% of the robots that are still alive when we die, we're going to switch corners. So the corner is going to be 0 plus 90, so it's going to be 90, and then it'll look for a different corner when it does that little calculation here to go to the specific corner, because now it's going to be 90 minus the heading, get that normal relative angle in degrees, and then move that direction. And then print out, I died and did poorly, switching corner to the other corner, and then I died but did well, and I will still use the same corner. And all of this is diagnostic stuff because we want to improve our bot. So that's really what the on-death event is for. You can't really do anything, but it will let you kind of print out some diagnostics and set some things for the next round. Okay, so that's breaking down the corners robot. There was a lot of info in there, so hopefully we didn't go too fast. But and I'm just looking here at the original authors. They would probably scoff at my explanation of their superior bot, but I did the best I could. Anyway, that's kind of how this Robocode works. And again, this wasn't meant to be an all-inclusive everything Robocode, but just rather kind of these are some ideas. And so you need to sit back in your head and say, what strategy do I think would work? And once I decide on a strategy that works, it's a matter of, okay, now that I've got the strategy in my head, let's translate that to Java code, right? Okay, well, hopefully that's helpful to take a look at that together. Robocode really is kind of fun to mess around with this and tweak it and test it against other bots and see how it does. But I guess that's it. Spencer out.